Gentlemen, welcome to Asgard. This time around, I'm pushing Asgard in a 10v10 with a Eurocorps armor deck, and it's going to be one hell of a push. We're going to go right to November, and we're taking the heaviest material to do that. I'm opening up here with a Leopard 2A5, which is a bit of a gamble, because I might come up against a Helo rush. So I'm also bringing a bit of air support, or anti-air, Flakpanzer Gepards, two of them, as well as getting quite a bit of AA support later on as we're setting up from, I believe, a bunch of Celtic helicopters. Here they are now, they're spawning in. It's hard to see a leader one. And leader one is doing a very, very good job with these Celtics. He's going to completely clear out any kind of sky threat here. Kess is also moving this way, so we got probably at this stage three players going this way. You can see that, I believe this is Kess, we got the Helos from Leader 1, we got Vist over here, and I think that from this side we're going to see Renzi 112 pushing up into Oscar and trying to get a foothold into Mike. It's a pretty high point game, we're going to have to go to 30,000, and to do that I want to get as many kills as possible with my Leos, my Leo 105s, I got Mortar 2s here with infantry, should I come up against bigger threats. Got a group of Leopard 2A4s here as well, as a Recon Leopard 1A1, to make sure I can actually spot targets. To back stuff up, I got Martyr VTS-1s, which are of course a nice unit to support tanks against lighter threats. Stuff that the tanks are not really required to kill, but which need killing, and I'm talking transports. The VTSs can easily take care of that with their decent rate of fire, while the main threats are being dealt with by the 2A4s, the 2A5s, and possibly the 1A5s. Also taking my command vehicle with me, I'm leaving my FOB here, Leader 1's going to leave his CV here, and I'm going to push mine into Yankee so we can start reinforcing November should we need to. You can see by the replay timer, we're only going to play for 30 minutes, and this is going to be quite a quick game. Now this is going to be one huge column of armor. All different nations, of course, and I think it always looks a bit silly because the game somehow doesn't seem to know what to use where and when. You can see that there's an Abrams squeezed in here between a Gepard and a 2A5. We got, I believe these are Vulcans, so that's Pivats bouncing between these tanks. And this is, actually, did I open up with two A5s? No, Leader 1's taking two Leopard 2A5s, that's the thing. I also got my own Leopard 2A5 back, and you can see that this armored column could easily be wiped out by any kind of bomber, if it wasn't for the fact that we have pretty much a Celtic defense wing up ahead here, which are killing off all of the enemy helicopters. So this team immediately lost a ton of points, and you can see that Leader 1 just took 600 points off of their hands, while losing only one Celtic. So these things did an amazing job, and that pretty much neutralized one player. I'm not entirely sure which one it was, because it was going a bit too fast for that, but I think it was Sasha Gray. Sasha probably went, well, I'm going to capture this area, and then he encountered Leader 1. At which stage he got completely obliterated and decided, well, this is not for me, bye. So, that happened. Anyway, Kesselring already has his CV here, and CVs are sometimes a bit quicker, especially if it's a wheeled vehicle like this. You do need to be careful with that, because sometimes you're going to find that a wheeled CV is going to arrive before your main defense or offensive group does, at which stage the CV of course can get killed off, but fortunately this stage it didn't happen, and now we have solid forward control of November. Now normally I would park my tanks in here, form a defensive line, but this time around I'm going, well, I got perfect side shots on T-80s, so let's take it. Mortar VTS-1s are taking a beating here from almost all of those tanks. Scored off 100 point, I believe it was a Tunguska back there. Yep, that was a Tunguska. You can see there's just a bit of armor on armor fighting, with these M11 or M1IPs getting shot in the sides, not really having a chance there. Leader 1 pushing up with his 2A5s, doing a solid job trying to kill off these T-80s. My tanks were a bit too far back. You can see that this little incline here is making it impossible for my tanks to shoot down, which means that I was not as effective as I should have been. Spotted a T-80 UK here. Someone was really in a mood to donate some points, so I was eager to get that thing. Lost a 1A5, unfortunately, but so be it. But I really wanted to capture this zone as quickly as possible. Because sometimes it's about morale, and I'm not talking troop morale, I'm talking player morale. If you can force players to lose so many units here that they're going, okay, I got nobody backing me up on this side, I'm gonna quit, fine. And they're gonna start blaming their team, they're gonna cause their team all sorts of distress, at which stage it becomes a lot easier for us to push up, move in, and get some more zones, as well as facing off against less players. So it's a bit of psychological player warfare here. Managed to kill off that command tank, kill off a transport, and I'm getting into this tree line as quickly as possible because my AA situation here is not good. If they would have come over with an SU-25K, they could have nailed quite a few tanks. But at this stage there was just not that much left of Red 4. They just didn't have anything here. Bringing in reinforcements, Martyr 1 with some more infantry if I want to do infantry on infantry situations here or capture these buildings. Pushing up with a Kyler, which is a nice support tank with an autocannon on top of it. Can be very effective when dealing with infantry. And the surviving Gepards, of course, with their main gun off. This one even has its stinger off. Same goes for the other one. I should not have put the stinger offline, but I usually select them, press H, and they turn off. And you can see that we're pushing up so far that we have control of Kilo, at least in the sense of units here. And it's just a matter of time before we find that command vehicle. This was again a wonderful cooperation between Leader 1, Kesselring, and myself here. And it being a 10v10, there wasn't any voice comms. It was just seeing what the other was doing, moving in along with it, and trying to fill gaps. So seeing what the other people did not have on their side, so that I could bring that unit. Now we got a couple of defensive units here being set up by, I believe it's Cozier 5 or Cozier S, let's call him Cozier S. And at this stage I'm just going to consolidate. I want to get a better hold on this position before I'm going to push up, because I'm looking at two spawn zones right here. Now my mortars, or my Panzer Grenadiers took a cluster bombing run, which was not too impressive, it didn't really do anything. But I believe that I did lose my 2A5. Not exactly sure what got it, but I think it was struck on, or it was hit by either an airstrike or a heavy tank. And I'm doing a bit of skirmishing here with 2A4s, but there is a T-72BU firing spheres into my Leopards, which is not something they are really going to survive for very long. You can see that Magic 9 here is really pushing us back, using all sorts of heavy USSR material, T-72BUs, T-80Us, Mi-28s, which caused another casualty along my Leopard 2A4s. Meanwhile, Leader 1 is pushing with Martyr 1s, which is going to bring more Panzer Grenadiers into this town. And we're putting up some smoke to make it more difficult for them to make that push impossible. Deployed some troops here along the right side, an AMX 1390 recon, Flak Gepard A1 to make sure I can deal with air threats to some extent, as well as a Leopard 185, which has a good commanding view over this area. Did go a bit aggressive there with my Alouette, spotted quite some stuff, but this flank did not really see a lot of action. It's just a holding force there. Bringing in some mortars, bring in some Roland 3s to make sure I can actually deal with aircraft, because they were becoming more and more of an issue. And I think that, oh here it is, my surviving Leopard 2A4 took a massive hit, or several hit, and I'm trying to get that thing repaired as fast as possible. So I'm bringing in a couple of Puma 330L logistics to make sure I can actually start resupplying both my own units and my teammates. At this stage it was just trying to keep going, trying to keep everything here in one piece, resupplying it, and at this stage I don't care if I resupply friendlies or my own units, I just want to keep this push going. Because once you have momentum like this, it's very, very difficult for the enemy to really defend against it, because they're constantly falling back. Now, quite a bit of artillery coming in here, doing a lot of damage to my units. You can see that I lost all but one of my Panzergrenadiers. And in the meanwhile, I'm also pushing some Panzergrenadiers into this town, along with a Martyr 1 and a Leopard 1 recon, so I can try and see what is going on here. Meanwhile, Leader 1 is being aggressive with this Martyr 1, just a bit of active scouting or aggressive scouting. And you can see that the Mi-28 just does not have a good line of sight at it. But as it's going to fly over, that's going to change, and somehow that Martyr did manage to take out the Mi-28. Did take quite a bit of hits there, but it survived, and it managed to destroy the helicopter, which is going to be one of the biggest threats there. We got a MiG-25 coming in with heavy cluster bombs, and they're going to completely wipe these units off the map. So that's my recon done there. And of course we're also going to see more and more and more artillery fire, because they do not want us to advance from this position. Renzi and Vist over here on the left flank are trying to spot stuff and get us targets, but we don't really have anything that can bridge this gap as far as distance is concerned. You can see that I am taking a bit of fire on my Gepards here. I managed to kill off one of the aircraft, but the MiG, the seed plane, survived. Over here, my units are being spotted, so I have to be careful. But they're doing quite okay. I was able to get quite far. And you can see that despite the 1390 having a base accuracy of 30%, at this range, and with lowest veterancy possible, it's an accuracy of 60%, which is rather nice for a unit that's only 20 points. Another MiG coming over, so that's another cluster bombing run. I did move my Gepard out of the way. If it had been back there, it would have been killed, but right now it survived, although barely. And it's just going to work on these transports, but it's only using 30mm or 35mm guns, so it's not going to be that effective against slightly armored targets. Now, all of my Pumas here are empty, and I'm taking those off, getting them back to base, which is back here. I still have my FOB, which is completely full. You can see that Leader 1 still has his Celtics here, which have been, or which should have been rearmed, but he just sent them back there without bothering to reuse them again. We're also looking at a bit of Panzergrenadier action here, as well as my AA, or whatever it was left of my AA, taking a lot of fire here. And they are scouting again on this position with Mi-28s and the Ka-52. Now the Ka-52 is the biggest problem here, because it has that seed missile. But I did manage to inflict quite heavy damage on the Mi-28, and now I'm pretty much defenseless. That is until the PIVADs show up from Kesselring, and they completely nail these two helicopters. Magic 9 surrenders, which is significant for me, as that was one of the guys who tried to push us back out of Mike here. Now the scores at this stage are 2500 points in favor of Blue 4. And you can see that I'm actually doing quite okay. I'm looking at 795 points. But I was feeding. I did sacrifice at least one Leopard 2A4. I believe a Martyr VTS died. I lost, or I'm about to lose, at least one mortar carrier here. And I think for an armored deck, that's okay. You can lose some stuff, because you're the main fist of the force. You're the main attacking movement. So without the armored deck here, it would have been quite a more difficult fight for Leader 1 as well as Kesselring here. Some more tanks getting sniped, as well as the airplanes taking a lot of fire from a quad combination of IHawks here, which are trying to get the Su-27 or the MiG-27 that came in but didn't get it. And Red 4 is now responding with a lot of artillery. You can see Graz firing here. We got peons trying to get a shot at us. Uragans. And this is all by Cozy RS. Let's see, Cozy has only scored 485 points, so he's not got a lot of stuff to show for the offense that, or for the amount of artillery fire that he's pushing on top of us. Not that effective artillery fire. but it is effective in the sense that it's holding us back. Kesselring unfortunately lost three of his Eyehawks here. One is surviving but almost out of fuel and definitely out of weapons. And they just keep sending in airstrike after airstrike. So we got a MiG-25 coming in, that's again the cluster bombing MiG. SU-25 is going to start shooting very high-end tanks here. You can see these MiG, or these M1IPs are taking a beating. It seems that they're also coming under smirch attack, but there wasn't too much of it. And they keep up constant air patrols with the MiG-31s. I got all of my logistics refueled and coming back. So I got a huge resupply circle here, and you can see that they are being drained incredibly quickly by repairing the Leopard 2A4, rearming the Patriot, probably. Even my command vehicle needs a bit of repair. I did lose mortar carriers there, I think. Oh, no, sorry, that moved. But the mortar carriers are being rearmed, which is always quite resource intensive. Shelling some BTR-90s here, but not too accurate. As well as giving the position of my mortars away, so I'm pulling those back as fast as possible, not presenting an easy target. And since the Pumas are all empty, I'm leaving all but one. I guess I didn't quite catch that one. Sending them back and ferrying another 4,000 points of supplies to the front line. Now, Cozy RS surrendered, which means that someone else got his units, and that someone else is going to have to manage all the artillery that we are taking fire from, which were his units. Major push coming in from Leader 1. I saw this and I decided to go along with it. So I got my Leopard 2A4s, which are getting into position. But I just did not have too much stuff here that I could send forward, because I was still reinforcing and getting ready for a push. You can see that I'm bringing in some new Gepard A1s to deal with any air threats that we might encounter here. But in the meanwhile, Leader 1 is taking a massive amount of losses here. He's offloaded all of his reservists, and at this stage I'm shelling this position with smoke as fast as possible to make sure that these reservists actually stand a fighting chance of moving up. As well as the Leopard 2s, as well as the 2A5s, that is, or the one 2A5, no sorry, split them up, the two 2A5s that are pushing up here. A couple of Leopard 2 standards pushing up, and with this smoke screen, which I gotta say is extremely effective because it completely saved this push, we are able to get a bit of a foothold into this zone. Of course, we're also making it more difficult for ourselves to deal with threats, but we need to get closer anyway. So at this stage I'm very, very happy with that smokescreen. You can see that the Leopards, as well as my Leopards, are pushing up, my Kylers, my 185s are moving in, my Recon Leopard, my Leopard 2A1s, got helos here standing by in case we're dealing with heavy tanks, and my Gepards should have moved up, but I forgot about those. So trying to push these guys back as fast as possible. And this is where we started to need AA, because recon helos of course are annoying, but they're not a main target. These things are much more of a threat, as well as the airstrikes coming in from those constant MiG-25 cluster bombers, which nailed two of my 185s and heavily damaged two others. And there you go, 80 points destroyed. I think that we may have hit that helicopter by blowing up a fuel truck. SU-25 nailed two of my Leopard 2A5s, or 2A4s. I was very, very unhappy with that loss, but that's what you get if you don't have enough AA. Leopard 2A5 being pulled back, and I think he lost one of them, probably due to that strike by the SU-25. Also seeing more tanks being brought in, T-62 MV-1s. Now the T-62 itself is not that big of a threat, but the Arcan missile on it is. So I'm trying to get up this road with my Leopard 2A1s, I'm trying to get shots on these guys, as well as pushing through this zone as fast as possible. Because the moment that we neutralize this command unit, that's the moment when we have control of this zone. Now I send my Pumas back to the front, and again they're empty, so I'm going to have to start sending those back. I lost one mortar, and the surviving mortar got joined up with this group, as well as bringing up some more Roland 3s, which I didn't have that many of. I think I had 5 in this group, which is a bit light. And now, of course, we're getting artillery again, taking a lot of damage to the Gepards, costing me again most of my AA here. Now, I managed to clear out this position, and I'm bringing in a Command Leopard. I was not the only one who was going to bring in a Command Vehicle, but a Command Leopard is the one that was the most survivable. And since this is a very, very heavily contested area, I thought that it was wise to bring in a Command Tank. In the meanwhile, I'm not sure how I'm going to pronounce this, I'm just going to call him Kot, brought in a Command Lynx, which made us get command of this zone. You can see another artillery strike came in, which quite significantly damaged these logistics, as well as panicking a martyr here. And I lost another Leopard 2A1. I think that was due to the front here. So time to bring in some reinforcements. AMX 1390s as well as AMX 10Ps with Mistral Infantry. Because I had it with these airstrikes at this stage. I was just getting tanks losses left, right and center. And I was going through my high-end tanks pretty quickly because I did not have the required amount of units to deal with them. My color gets nailed there by an Akula, and that's another reason why I wanted to get a lot more AA in here. My Command Leopard is also pushing up. I'm going to park that in this tree line and get it ready to start moving into Lima. I'm going to zoom out, and you can see that Blue 4 at this stage is very, very heavily pushing on the right flank. Center is pretty much equal. There's not a lot going on over here on the left flank, but on the uttermost left flank we got infantry fighting against Charlie, and this is also quite a difficult zone to push into. Anyway, on my side, AMX 1390s are reaching the front, so I have a bit of sight here. These things only have good optics, but they're very cheap. I can spread out quite a few of them and get more optics and more intel on this zone. Now you can see that there's an AV which is just casually hovering, nailed one AMX 1390. So it's time to start pushing up with these Mistrals, trying to deal with the helicopters. Over on the right, we got Kessel, and Kessel was taking a lot of fire from these T-90s. Unfortunately, we don't really have anything that can deal with that at this stage, so we're just going to have to try and slug it out. His Abrams are taking a beating, because they're significantly inferior when compared to those T-90s. But at this range, they have a pretty good chance to actually get in there. See, there's smoke, and I believe that's smoke coming in from my tanks, or from my artillery. Trying to save those M1s, but in the end, the M1s died a lot faster than I had expected. Which led to basically providing a smoke screen for the T-90s so that the T-90s survived instead of the Abrams. Mistake on my part, but I couldn't have saved them from the Mi-24Vs anyway. Now, got another super heavy coming up, a Leclerc. And this Leclerc was pushing up quite aggressively, up to the point where I thought, well, that might have been a bit much, so I pulled it back. Getting into the tree line here, which somehow has enough cover to hide a tank. Not sure how that works, but okay. Pushing in with more Gepards, Mistrals as well on the left flank and the right flank to deal with helicopters and aircraft, because these guys are pretty good against both. Missiles are fast, have a good range, and they carry quite a few of them, especially in a group of three of these units. Nailed an Akula there, instantly eliting one of these groups. You can see that they started out at Veteran, and they instantly went all the way up to Elite, just for killing a helicopter that is five times, or what was it? It was a K-52, so I think it was five times more expensive than the group itself. Pushing up here again with the surviving Leopard 2A5 from Leader 1, as well as my Leclercs, my 2A, or my one Leclerc, my 2A4s, and with my Command Leopard here, I managed to neutralize this command zone, so that I at least don't have control of it anymore. Lost my Leclerc, again, too aggressive, and I also lost my Command Leopard. Again, too aggressive. I was going too fast and too far here, so I'm bringing in another Command Leopard right away to try and deal with anything that could be in this area. I'm making sure that they don't have control of it so they cannot reinforce it. Gepard 1, or Gepard A1s, pushed in too aggressively and came up against T-62s. Which are just being spammed into this area. But the main problem here were the ATGMs that were hiding in this town. You can see that they just nailed the command vehicle that was brought in by one of my allies here, as well as firing ATGMs at my leopards, which again died. So that's another two leopards down the drain. Mistrals are casually nailing all the helicopters that came flying in from Foxtrot over here, and now we're pushing heavily on two zones. We got Kot over here, as well as Vist, which are pushing onto Foxtrot and neutralizing it, and Lima is also getting pushed back farther and farther. And of course at this stage we're getting more and more points. 23,000 against 16,000. It was just a no-go for Blue 4, or for Red 4. I finally put those AMX Hot 2s to work, and they killed at least one, maybe two of the T-90s there. And I remembered that I had a couple of Cassiopeias in the deck, so I decided to bring in those to give me a bit more supporting units here, as well as trying to hunt down a CV with those autocannons. IL-102 bomber comes in, but at this stage we're ready. We got enough AA here. And a bit of kill stealing there as far as I'm concerned, but my Mistral should not have taken that kill, because Kesselring here was doing most of the work with the IHawks as well as the PIVATs. But I was really happy with the Mistrals here, because you can see that one group of these went elite as well. The other two groups are very, very veteran as well, and they're just trying to nail any kind of unit that they can spot. Cassiopeias are coming in, as well as an elevated recon, but again, lost it due to being too aggressive with one specific unit. If I had pushed in here with a bit more tanks, that would have been safer. I again have my Command Leopard in here, so they no longer have control of this zone. We have control of the adjacent zone. So Leopard 1A5s from my team, or from my faction, are coming in to engage from the flank here, as we try to find that command vehicle, and at this stage I had spotted it right there. So the last thing that the Alouette did before it died. Now I had some Roland 3s here, which pushed up too aggressively and got killed off. You can see that those Bruises are just casually killing off any helicopter that happens to get too close. I scored 120 points there. I'm not too sure what that was. May have been another helicopter. I think that was the logistics helo that was out there. You can see whatever's left of it sticking out of the ground. Sniped one, maybe two of the AA guns here with a Tornado ECR that flew over. And at this point, I'm one of the highest earning players in this team. 4,000 versus 4,500 and 5,000 points. So I was doing rather well in this game. But just being very, very aggressive, as well as having excellent backup from Kesselring, Kot, and Leader 1 with all of his units. You may call this reserve it spam, by the way, that Leader 1 is doing, but it is being effective, especially when he tried to push in with all his reservists there. It made it possible for us to distract the tanks long enough to get in here, take control of the buildings, push all of our tanks through, and nail the command vehicle that was hiding somewhere back there. So, reservist spam? Maybe. But it was bloody effective. And at this stage, it's just mopping up. I got my Leopard 1A5s, which are over here, while they actually really shouldn't be. Cassiopeias getting a few shots, but I think that the Leopards in the end took the kill. And that is it for Lima. We cleared out this zone, and we have control of the adjacent Foxtrot zone. And you can see that this is resulting in a heavy push here by Kot. Kot also neutralized Echo, which leaves only Alpha here in the back, as well as Charlie. But Alpha is the one that we want, because it's an air reinforcement zone. So cut that off, and you got all the aircraft under our control. Another command being brought in here. Last command from Andrew ZA being spotted in this sector. Killed that off by Kot's forces, capturing it for our team. I believe that I am going to try and bring in some, maybe two Leclercs together. Yep, there they are, but they're not going to get there, because before they get there, we're going to finish off with a points victory. You can see that another bombing run is coming in from those MiG-25s, but the bombs didn't even hit the ground. and we got the game. Now, as mentioned, I was feeding quite a bit. I lost 3,000 points, but I gained 4,000. So, yes, I lost quite a few forces, but as far as I'm concerned, to a good end. Because through that push, along with Leader 1, as well as, let's see, where is he? Kesselring, we managed to get through. And that getting through forced, initially, through Leader 1's push, to force Sasha Grey to quit. You can see that the 600 points that he lost was probably those helicopters, which forced him to rage quit instantly, leaving them with 9. And as we pushed harder and harder, we saw Cozy RS leave, we saw Magic 9 leave, probably because they were having in-team conflicts, as always happens with 10v10s if it's not going your way. And all of that, as well as good coordination with attack markers and good players, allowed this team to win. So, bit of armored pushing there, and I hope you liked it. If you did, hit that like button. If you are not subscribed yet, please do so, because I try to get a new video up every day, and I wouldn't want you to miss it. If you want me to support my channel, I got a link to that in the description down below, as well as links in the description for sending in your deck or your gameplay. I've also provided the deck code for the deck that I was using in this gameplay, so if you like the armored deck that you saw, you can just import that from the description. Anyway, I hope you like watching it, and I'll see you in the next one.